Welcome back to the show. You're still watching Saloon Talk and I'm your girl Savaria. We are still here at Spectra Saloon. As you can see, they are working on my hair. And at the end, I'm going to show you the finished version. But we're still talking to the beautiful Mrs. all the way from Miss Tourism. And we are still diving into the topics because people are out there and they are really biased about the crowns. They are biased about what it means to be in a pageantry. So now we are going to get to know more and also what they are doing them as the misses. So you guys talked about Let the Pearl Shine campaign. What is it all about? Oh yeah, I know the Pearl means Pearl of Africa, Uganda, you know, cleaning, but like, what are some of the things that you guys have done within that campaign, if you can tell us more about it?
Like how the name is Let the Pearl Shine. So when you clean, we go out to the communities, especially our tourism sites, and then we clean the area. We make sure that the place is really clean so that when the tourists come, they because they love clean places, yeah, and we have to make sure the place is good. So this project is its main focus is to make Uganda be a clean tourism destination. So when we go to the communities and clean the communities, we make sure that the place is clean.
Okay, because it is well known that besides maybe agriculture, tourism is one of Uganda's biggest sectors, and we have very many tourists coming in. So I think it is very, very good to be able to participate. So those who want to participate in the campaign, like, what's the process?
Well, as Miss Tourism Queens, well, it's not only for the Miss Tourism Queens, it's for the whole of Uganda, for everyone to participate. To join it, you have to just record yourself, and then you just tell people, you engage everyone to join the campaign and make sure that the places are clean, to tell them that we come as one and we make sure that the place is clean. And then at the end of the recording, we hashtag Let the Pearl Shine. Yes.
Okay, I'm looking forward to also be joining the Let the Pearl Shine campaign. Expect my video very time
soon.
From
the recording, you can just write it down and then you hashtag Let the Pearl Shine, because it's for everyone to participate
as long as you are in Uganda, you are able to participate in this campaign.
Yes, every city.
Okay, people out there, you are not sure of these things. You are not aware. Now you are aware. Don't start saying, but we have not told you. Okay, so now you guys are handing over in September, I think. Yes, September, right? You're handing over to another crew. They're going to crown another. Aren't you feeling bad that you're handing over your crowns? Wait, let me ask. Do you get to keep these crowns or are the others made? Or it's the same crown you guys hand over?
Well, okay, we're handing over in September and it is sweet. The crown is sweet, the pageantry is sweet, and we do not have to be selfish because we have to give opportunities to other young girls out there to make their dreams come true, because if I did it, they can also do it. They can make their dreams come true. So we do not have to feel selfish, even if it is sweet. So we have to give that opportunity to the next person, to the next generation, to feel what I am feeling right now.
It's really not a nice feeling, I have to be honest. But of course, it's a reigning thing that's always up to be for a year. And you go there knowing I have to go do this for 1 year and then give it to another person. So it's just the mindset.
Okay, for me, I believe the crown is more than this that we were. I feel the crown is the person, you feel me? And it says that even if someone else takes the crown, the fact that I once wore the crown, I still own it and I can still run projects, because what they train us to be or to do is not something we're going to act for 1 year and then drop off after after your period, right? So I believe, okay, for me, it doesn't hurt. It actually makes me more excited to see more people come to get what I once had.
So what's next for you? You personally, you as Leona, what's next? What are you going to do after handing over the crown?
Well, after handing over the crown, I believe the first thing I really want to do, and I hope we are going to do it, is have the girls into more of a training session after the crown. Because, you know, after the crown, many things come up. You know, there are those that came with high hopes and now they are now low. There are those that are going to get depressed. Yeah. So I believe the first project I would want to do is have like a girl empowerment, something that is going to involve all the queens.
As earlier on discussed, that we have personal projects, and then it being that we're not going just to stop but continue with the Miss Tourism office, we shall be engaged. I will have my projects running, so I think I'll be busy on that.
I'm talking about personal trip. You take yourself to the Maldives, you sit by the water, you know, you look, you embrace. You once were queen, you know, like you said, once a queen, always a queen. But like, you once had the crown, but now it has gone on. Like, don't you people also, like, don't you guys want that? Or you guys have a lot to do before, like, all that?
No, go to the Maldives.
Okay, so, when are you planning? Let me start with Charity. When are you planning to have kids and get married? Well, that is not like in the nearby.
It's not
prospects.
In the nearby. Near.
But at one point,
yes,
one
at
time.
At one point, I'll have children. Yes.
Being an independent woman, because all of you guys are independent, even me, I'm independent. But being an independent lady, and you have hustled your way to where you are now, and you decide, like, God miraculously gives you a child and tells you, oh, it's your time, I want you to have one now, and obviously you decide to have it, would you want your baby daddy to be in the picture, or would you rather remain an independent lady and take care of everything yourself?
If God miraculously does that, I'll surely keep the baby, and I would love to be with the baby daddy, because I believe a family is not only of one person. Not only of a man taking care of a child, a woman taking care of a child, but it consists of two people, a father and a mother. So if we come together as a family, we give support to this child. So if I'm alone, of course, independent women would be like, I can't take care of my child. I am able to take care of my child. But I believe as a family, as a man and a woman, we have the ability to do this, because a man has to give that a fatherly image.
Yeah, the role of a father.
Yes,
the
role of a father to the child, to teach his son of how women are treated, and also treat his daughter how women are supposed to be treated, or how men are supposed to be treated, and also how to behave in the society.
All right, so Liana, same question goes to you. And then also, in addition to that, which country, besides the roles that Miss Tourism comes with, which country would you love to go? Be like, ah, I'd rather go there for like, it's just a private vacation.
First the question. I think a good thing you said, it's a miracle. So I do not know if the baby daddy is in the picture or not. All I would want is to raise my child with an open mind. So if the guy is responsible, but by all means, whoever that guy would be, he has to be responsible. So I think I would want him in that picture.
Okay.
Yeah.
And your trip, which country, which destination would you rather? Because obviously, being a Miss Tourism, your role doesn't end even though you hand over the crown. You are still part of the cabinet. You are still part of the Miss Tourism team, the whole entire team, from the executives, the producers, but you are still part of the team. So which country would you choose to go to just to have your enjoyments, but also I'm very sure you'd encourage them to come back to Uganda and see how beautiful the Pearl of Africa is?
I think I have rare taste. I would prefer Egypt because of the desert and all that. And plus, I think they would also want to have an experience this side. So I would strategically go there and tell them that as much as you guys are in a desert, we have some paradise in Uganda. Please come.
I don't even know what it's called. Okay, so now you see my mind is on a very different thing. The same question goes to you. What would you do in the situation if at all God gave you a miraculous child? Would you decide to carry it out as an independent, like the way women be like, I'm gonna be with my kid, I don't need a man in my life? Would you be that woman, or would you be a woman who wants both family values installed in the child?
Oh, sure. taking the religious aspect of life, where a man has to be with a woman, I would really love to stay together with him. That is if God does it. Yeah, that's in the future, not now. Yeah.
Why is it women are scared of giving birth?
Okay. As for me, I'm not scared. But then it's just about the timing, yes. It's about being ready, being focused. What have you got before that? Because it's not an easy journey to be a mother, I think. Though I'm not yet experienced, yeah, but I think it's not an easy journey. So you have to be prepared.
They say you can never know what it means to be a mom unless you have a child. So I can never tell, neither can you. Yeah, so which country, like I said, which country would you decide to go, like, for like a personal vacation? You're like, I want to go to this country, I want to enjoy myself. Which country would be like your destination? Because you never know, the ambassadors are watching. They'll be like, ah, oh, Miss Tourism, let us give you a free everything, you know.
Okay, I feel like she spoke my mind. I had Egypt in my mind, maybe Zanzibar. But I would feel more, why not they come visit us so that we explore Uganda together. Yeah, sure.
Okay, all right. Let us go back into a commercial break. When we come back, we have reached the end of the show, but we're coming back for the last segment. Go down to our social media platforms and tell us your opinion of what a modern woman should be and what is your country destination. Me personally, I would love to visit Paris. I want to see the Eiffel Tower. I want to be on the last floor. But I'm such of a crybaby. I don't like experiencing things alone. Let us go into a commercial break. When we come back, we still have more for you. Welcome back. You are still watching Saloon Talk. We have reached the last segment, and I've been in the company of the beautiful ladies all the way from Miss Tourism, and they've been telling us what it is to be a Miss Tourism in this day-to-day life and what it is to be a modern woman. So you people, if you are there out there and you're scared of achieving your dreams, you're scared of achieving your goals, I do not know what you're thinking, because we have living legends of what you think about can actually come true, what you dream about can actually become a reality. So we're not gonna jump into questions because I think we've exhausted everything, but you're gonna like, everybody of you is gonna talk to the girls, the young girls out there who really want to join the pageantry regardless, but most especially Miss Tourism. But they are scared, oh, it requires this, it requires all that, it requires, and there are those who are out there, like I said, there is this bias that being in a pageantry, you're going to be having men wanting special attention from you just in order to get something. So you feel free to tell them what they should expect and how fun it can actually be.
Well, to any girl out there, you want to shine, please take up the platform. Pageantry is a platform that would probably push you out and give you a platform to showcase who you are. Do what you do best. We have talent shows. Probably you're a dancer out there and you've not had platform. This is a place for you. So I encourage any kind of girl out there, if you really want to do this, if you want to be a queen once in your life, please, this is a platform for you. There is a mindset we normally have that when you're going for any pageant, Miss Uganda, Miss Tourism Uganda, you should be more of a kind of girl, you know, those fancy girls and all that. But I promise you, it's nothing close to that. That's just what society paints it as, but it's not actually what it is.
Yeah, my advice is that you do not have to feel scared, because pageantry is not about the body physique, but it's about they check about your intellect, your poise, the way you put yourself together and all that. So you do not have to be scared about maybe body shaming and all that, but to just, you know, I was going to say to put your balls together, but since we're ladies, we are not.
To the listeners, to the ladies, to the women out there, as the topic of today, we were on modern women. Honestly, it's a nice journey to join pageantry, but then depending on the outside perception about pageantry, I think you need to hear this, and let's clear this off, that to join in, you don't need any big qualifications. You're a woman, you're a lady, you want stand up, be this upright woman, go for what you want, and then there's nothing to carry so much, really, that I need this, I need that, I need a good body, I need a good color, I need... No. It's come as you are, bring yourself, and then they will teach you definitely what to do. Because Miss Tourism, first of all, Miss Tourism Uganda is a home away from home, if I may say. Because being there, you don't even miss home so much, honestly, because they take good care of you. Imagine, honestly, pageantry gives you a platform to express yourself, to explore places. Honestly, I reach places I'd never been, and then see me now, maybe we'll be on TV, and then this is something like, it's not easy to reach, but check, this is a platform really that pushes you. Like, it doesn't bring you in the plate, but then it shows you how to reach there.
You have heard from the beautiful ladies all the way from the Miss Tourism Uganda, and they have told you a little bit of their experience, what they went through, what they are going to do after handing over the crown. And also, you out there, you are inspired by these beautiful ladies to take up what you really want. They are an inspiration. They are a real life, how should I call it, real life avatar, is it? They are a real life of everything that you can achieve. If you set your minds to something, you are able to achieve it. Thank you, ladies, for coming through. I am so happy to have hosted you today. After here, where are you planning to go? You're having some Miss Tourism projects to carry out, or you're gonna like go home first, relax, sleep, watch some Netflix?
Actually, after this, we're going to, for our preparation, we're going to Gulu, Northern Uganda. We have shows there running, and then we will have to join in the Let the Power Shine project. Yeah.
Tiresome. Don't you get tired at some point? You'd be like, these people are overworking me. I'm moving from place to place. Like, don't you guys get tired?
It's actually something we love to do. Tourism is moving from one place to another within 12 hours or 24 hours for pleasure. Imagine pleasure. So we just go for pleasure. It's something we love to do. So we don't have to, we don't really say, these people are overworking us and all that. It is pleasure. We love it.
Okay. As we are signing out, you're going to remind the viewers your name and you like your current position in Miss Tourism. Yes, before we sign out.
Actually, mine is more than a name. Mine is more than a name.
Oh, okay. Yes. All right. No problem.
Let me put this down. So, once again, my name is Alaba Charity, Miss Tourism Northern Uganda. As a Miss Tourism Northern Uganda, I urge everyone in Uganda to come to the northern region. I believe a big percentage of the Ugandans and tourists do not exceed the central region, the Jinja, or the western side. But a few people just go to Karamoja and the northern region. And I believe because of the LRA war, they have a mindset that the northern people are hostile. So I want to let you know that from me, we are not hostile. We are not hostile. We are very hospitable people. So I urge you to come to Northern Uganda to tour around, because we have tourism sites available. We have the Atiak Forest Reserve. It has black and white colobus monkeys. The youths love water. We have beautiful, romantic, magnificent waterfalls, and that is the Aru Falls campsite. So when you come to Gulu, and then you head to Pade, that is where we find the Aru Falls campsite. We have hills that you have to hike. Yes, I said you have, because it is good for your soul. It is good for your soul to hike and experience new places. So when you come to Northern Uganda, we have all these goodies. Perhaps you might be worried about accommodation. Mm-mm. The hoteliers did a very good job. We have hotels that have swimming pools. We have hotels that have ACs and so much more that you can find in hotels, massage parlors and all that. And then you might be maybe wondering over, maybe you want to sleep in a grass thatched hut or something like that. We also have grass thatched houses that have modern amenities. So you sleep in your grass thatched house and it is self-contained. It has AC, but it is grass thatched. So do not hesitate to come to the northern region because we have all these goodies. Maybe you're worried about what you will eat. We also have the matoke that you love. We have the vinyewa that you love. And then the delicacies that are in the northern, I think most of you know malakwang, but we have something called olel. My God, when you taste it, heaven on earth. We have agira. Jesus Christ. I cannot explain this because you'll not even taste it when I'm just talking. It is good to explore and experience it. That is how you'll tell that this is something here that feels like heaven on earth. So it is a place that you need to really check out and explore because it carries a lot of history that is very important in Uganda. So please come to Northern Uganda because we have goodies for you. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Leon and Naturinda, first runner up Miss Tourism Chigezi. Well, I'm from the hills of Chigezi, where we have the beautiful hills, we have Lake Winyonyi, we have the mountain gorillas, we have Mount Mugahinga, we have Mugahinga. Okay, it's so much in Chigezi. And I promise you one thing about Chigezi, no place is as cold as Chigezi in Uganda. It's a place you should visit. It's a place you're supposed to be, the sweetest land of Uganda. Thank you so much.
Hi, once again, Naken Fatima, my name's second runner, Miss Tourism Karamoja. You're welcome to Karamoja, the land of mighty warriors. We have a national game park there, that's Kidepo. We have two game reserves, that's Pian Upe and Bokora Madeniko. We have just a lot. You're welcome. Thank you.
Alright, so we have reached the end of the show. You know, we are running late. The minutes are counting and you know, these beautiful ladies have to work. You know, every minute and every second counts. You have been watching Saloon Talk. We are here every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. right here on Urban TV. So make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend to tune in. And also, remember, we talk about topics that people do not want to talk about. We cover topics that people out there are biased of talking about. We are going to be covering with different celebrities, with different influential people that we have in the country. So stay tuned for more topics. If you have any comments you want to tell us, you can go down to our social media platforms. We are here at Spectra Saloon Bukolobi. If you want to get your hair done, if you want to get your nails done, if you want to get your beard done, if you're a man, you want to get a facial, you want a massage, Spectra Saloon has everything for you. Do not be underestimated by the small size of the door. Trust me, the saloon is very big and vast within. So make sure you come down through. Your hair is going to get styled. I don't think we're going to get the time to show you my workout hair, but hopefully the producer can get a cutaway and you guys see the products that this saloon uses and what you are going to get. Though your money is worth everything that you want to look for. So make sure you're tuned in every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. You're watching Saloon Talk. I'm your girl, Savara Hughes. Feel free to follow me on all my social media platforms. That is Savara Hughes 53, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. Yeah, Snapchat people now. We are people nowadays, you know, Snapstreak. Anyway, catch you again next week with another episode. Stay tuned.